Today, I wish to share a short message and want to assure you that we at Grain SA are ready and geared to continue to assist and support all grain farmers of South Africa in many ways. Alle voorspoed met die afhandeling van die wintergraan oesproces om die waardevolle kleingraan in die silo's te kry. Ons weet die uitdagings is baie en dat beerdkrag dit verder bemoeilik. Ek weet ook dat ons dit eerst kan tel as die graan in die silo val, maar ek glo en vertrouw die geseënde jaar sal suksesvol afgehandel word, specifiek in die Weskaap as ook die binnenlandse koornboere. Met die somerseisoen wat nou al goed aan die gang is en uit 'n lekker nat Pretoria wil ek vandag graag die mielie, soja, sonneblom, grondboon en sorgumboere alle sterkte toewens vir die res van die somerseisoen waarmee julle besig is. Ons glo en vertrou almal dat dit weer eens 'n geseënde jaar gaan wees wat voorlê. Ons het die afgelope tyd al telke male oor die nuwe seisoen gepraat. Maar wat beteken dit? Vir my is dit veel meer as net die plant van 'n geoes. Dit gaan oor die dinge in die landbou en die land wat aan die verander is. Met die pas afgelope verkiesing wat ons nog nie presies weet wat die implikasies gaan wees nie, as ook vergaderings, voorleggings en toesprake wat ek die laaste maand bygewoon het, kan ek nie anders as om my opregte opgewondenheid met julle te deel nie. Ek beleef 'n verandering in die houding en toewyding van die regering se kant af, spesifiek om die bedryf te ondersteun en samewerking te kry. Persoonlik is ek versigtig optimisties, want ek weet dit gaan maar vereis dat ons sitplekgordels vasmaak. Maar dit kan groot besigheidsgeleenthede vir die toekoms inhou. Hence, I truly believe that we now have the unique opportunity and that the time is right and ripe to ensure that we as organized agriculture support and drive agriculture-friendly policies. And that is exactly what we at Grain SA are doing on a daily basis. The global energy crisis, coupled with the aftershock of COVID on global supply chain bottlenecks, are creating a supply shock in global fertilizer market, hence the spiking prices. This is different from the previous shock in 2008, which was caused by a demand shock. So we are seeing new real urea prices, for example. Analysts believe that this should turn around towards March, April 2022. Our key challenge is profitability, and under these circumstances, I want to ask and propose that farmers carefully plan their production systems and processes. Constantly rethink what you are doing. You need to become more efficient in every season. We all know that maximum yield or top yields are not necessarily your most profitable level of output. Especially not when resources and inputs like fertilizer are scarce and with the resulting price pressure. Ensure that you can lock in a decent profit, even if that means that your yield might be lower than the previous year. Carefully consider your resources and use the scarce one at their best or optimal potential. I want to close by thanking you all for your continued support and contributions during this past year, especially to you all dedicating your precious family and business time. We need you, the industry needs you, and more importantly, your fellow farmers need you. Therefore, we appreciate you, and please let us know where we can assist and support you further. Let's keep having that fruitful conversations. All the best for the rest of the season. May you and your families experience a truly blessed Christmas season, and I personally look forward to meeting you all in person in 2022. Groetnis, en onthou om dit te geniet. Dis 'n groot voorreg.